top 8 answers on the board. Name a way a woman flirts with a man at a bar. Renee.
Smiles.
Smiles. Show it to me. Smiles.
Eyes.
Eyes. Like, show me. Eyes. Pass the play.
We're gonna play.
Okay. Miss Devlin, girl, let me find out what you know about this here. Name a way a woman flirts with a man at a bar.
Skim a wave.
Oh, give him a wave. Give him a wave.
No.
Sexy wave.
Yeah, it's not
that
sexy.
Gabrielle, name a way a woman flirts with a man at a bar.
Writes her number on a napkin.
Good answer.
Right. We ain't flirting at this point. We going to get it. Write your number on a napkin. All right, David, we got 2 strikes. You got to be careful. Other family can steal, man. Come on.
Buy some a drink, Steve.
Buy a drink. Yeah. Ja-Ja, 2 strikes. Other family can steal. Name a way a woman flirts with a man at a bar.
She bumps into him.
Bumps into him. Marquita, we got 2 strikes. We got to be careful. The other family can steal.
Blows a kiss.
Blows a kiss.
That's all he got here? I was praising the Lord.
Blow a kiss. Name a way a woman flirts with a man at a bar.
Woo, there's a lot of things you can do, but we're gonna go with play with your hair.
Play with Steve. Your hair. Yeah. Number 8. 7.
Chat, sexy boy.
6.
Dancing.
Top 5 answers on the board. Here we go. Name something you'd be surprised the boss was wearing under his suit. Tina?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Speedo.
Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
George, how you doing, man?
Good.
Name something you'd be surprised that the boss was wearing under his suit.
His pajamas, Steve.
Ooh, his pajamas. Yeah. Hello, B.
Hello. Hola, Steve.
Hola. Hola. ¿Cómo está?
Muy, muy bien. Gracias.
Yeah. Poquito. Poquito.
¿Tú también, poquito?
Yeah. Caliente.
¿Por qué?
Yeah. Okay. I don't know where you're going with this.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'm grown
I might
ass
be free
man.
Tonight.
All right. I'm going to tell you right now, ain't nothing but a situation over here, B. What do you do for a living, B?
Well, I am a police support specialist for Modesto Police Department in Modesto, California.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. All right, let's go, B. Name something you'd be surprised the boss was wearing under his suit.
Women's underwear.
Oh! Women's underwear. Jess, my man, name something you'd be surprised the boss was wearing under his suit.
Another suit, Steve.
Another suit. All right, we got 2 strikes. We got to be careful. Hello, Rosie. How are you?
Hi, I'm great, Steve.
Name something you'd be surprised the boss is wearing under his suit.
I think he's wearing a bathing suit.
Ooh. A bathing suit. Tina, name something you'd be surprised the boss is wearing under his suit.
Let's go with long johns.
Long johns.
Long johns.
Long johns. Name something you'd be surprised the boss is wearing under his suit.
We're gonna say a diaper.
Diaper. Number five.
Superhero outfit.
Four. All right, ladies, top eight answers on the board. Name something a man might kiss with more passion than he does his wife.
His kids.
His kid. What? His kids.
His girlfriend.
His girlfriend. Shelby, name something a man might kiss with more passion than he does his wife.
What about his golf clubs?
Ooh, good answer.
His golf clubs. Here we go. Name something a man might kiss more passion with more passion than he does his wife.
What about his dog, Steve?
What good answer?
Not my husband, though.
Your dog.
I've seen it before.
Your dog. Stephanie, how are you?
Hey, sexy Steve.
Stephanie. Better watch yourself. Thank God for social distancing. Stephanie, that threw me off a little bit. Hey, sexy Steve. All right, let's go. Name something a man might kiss with more passion than he does his wife.
His mother.
Wow.
It's up there.
No, let's hope not. His mama. Miss Vicky ain't,
Pee-pee.
All right, welcome to the show, Miss Vicky.
Thank you.
Name something a man might kiss with more passion than he does his wife.
I'm gonna say his fishing pole.
His fishing pole. All right, we got two strikes. We gotta be careful now, Stacey. McClendon family can still give me something a man might kiss more passion than he does his wife.
I'm gonna say his truck.
Good his answer. Truck. Hey, Shelby, two strikes. Other family can steal. Something a man might kiss with more passion than he does his wife.
What about his boat?
His boat. Yeah. Oh. All right, family. Here's your chance. Name something a man might kiss with more passion than he does his wife.
We're gonna say his money.
Yeah. His money. Number seven.
Food on the beach.
Six.
Winning lotto ticket.
Number five. Top seven answers on the board. Listen carefully, fellas. Name a baked good that a baker might call a woman when he's flirting with her.
Honey bun.
All right, now, Connie, honey bun.
Let's go.
Sweetie pie.
Sweetie pie. Ooh,
that's a good one.
Pass the play.
You want to play?
We're gonna play, Steve.
Yeah. Kapua, name a baked good that a baker might call a woman if you're flirting with her.
My chocolate cake.
My chocolate cake. All right now, my little chocolate thing up in here. Come on, girl, she don't like it chocolate.
Come on, be up there.
Chocolate cake.
Good job.
Hey, Sonny. Name a baked good a baker might call a woman when he's flirting with her.
Cookie.
Hey, Cookie. Roy, give me a baked good a baker might call a woman he's flirting with.
Muffin, Steve.
Muffin. Ani, give me a baked good a baker call a woman he's flirting with her.
Donut.
Oh, good answer.
You know, donut.
What's up there, Steve?
Donut! Connie, give me a baked good. A baker might call a woman when he's flirting with her.
A Danish? You're my Danish? My sweet Danish? It's good, yeah, Steve. Oh,
yes.
I mean, you can rephrase this Danish answer all you want to. Danish? My sweet Danish? You little sugary Danish? Danish! All right, Kapoor, we got two strikes. You gotta be careful. More family can steal. Give me a baked good. A baker might call a woman he's flirting with.
How about a croissant?
A croissant! Good. All right, guys, name a baked good that a baker might call a woman he's flirting with.
Pudding.
Pudding? That was a good answer. Number 7. Six.
Oh.
Point value's triple. Top 4 answers on the board. Name something the hospital nurses eat every day to keep the married doctors away.
Garlic.
Garlic. Wow. Pass the point. Let's play. I got you. Chrissy, name something the hospital nurses eat every day to keep the married doctors away.
I'm gonna go with onions.
Onions. Christopher, name something the hospital nurses eat every day to keep the married doctors away.
I'm gonna say fish.
Fish. Cindy, name something the hospital nurses eat every day to keep the married doctors away.
A pastrami sandwich.
Pastrami sandwiches. All right, Megan, we gotta be careful now. We got 2 strikes. If it's there, you're still alive. But if it's not there, the other family can steal and win. Name something the hospital nurses eat every day to keep the married doctors away.
There's a saying, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. I'm going with an apple, Steve.
That's great. That's smart. Apple. Yeah. I would have never thought of that. I would have never thought of that. That's pretty good. Anthony?
I'm going to say they're words, Steve. They're words.
They eat their words. One answer does it. This is it. Name something the hospital nurses eat every day to keep the married doctors away.
We're gonna go with sauerkraut, Steve.
Sauerkraut.
Yeah.
This is for the win. Sauerkraut. Number 4. All right, here we go, guys. Top 7 answers on the board. Name an occasion a married man looks forward to because he can flirt with other women.
A wedding.
A wedding. Night out with the guys.
Play.
We'd
like to play.
Let's go, buddy. Let's go. Well, Yash, let's meet your family.
All right, Steve. This is my beautiful wife, Kirsten, married for 10 years. We've got three children together, two boys and a girl. My amazing sister-in-law, Lindsay. My little brother, Brian. And my middle brother, Mustache Mike.
All right, let's play. Kirsten. Name an occasion a married man looks forward to because he could flirt with other women.
How about a family get-together?
Flirt at the family gathering. Lindsay, name an occasion a married man looks forward to because he could flirt with other women.
Strip club.
Strip club.
Good answer.
All right, we got two strikes. We got to be careful now. Mac and family can steal.
Bachelor party, Steve.
Bachelor party. Mike, two strikes. Mac and family can steal. Name an occasion a married man looks forward to because he can flirt with other women.
You got it. You got it. You got it. You got one. Put it out there. You got it. Sorry, Steve.
Name an occasion a married man looks forward to because he can flirt with other women.
Well, we're going to say divorce, Steve. He's getting divorced. Yeah. Woo! Come on.
Divorce. Y'all don't know. You don't know. Number seven.
Wow.
Six. Four. Top seven answers on the board. Name someone wives might flirt with during an average day.
The delivery man, UPS.
The delivery man, UPS. Christina.
Their neighbor.
Their neighbor.
Play.
Good plans. All right. Abby, somebody wives might flirt with during an average day.
The pool boy, Steve.
The pool boy. Cindy, someone wives might flirt with during an average day.
My boss.
Your boss. Karen, name someone wives might flirt with during an average day.
Well, you know, if the plumber came over to fix my plumbing.
If the plumber come over to fix your plumbing, that ain't flirting. Plumber. And name someone wise might flirt with doing an average day.
I'm gonna go with their personal trainer.
Their personal trainer. Angela.
Not me, Steve, but my husband's best friend.
Oh. 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 Hell going on down there where y'all stay. Husband's best friend. All right, Abby, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Stone family can steal, okay? Name someone wives might flirt with during an average day.
How about the gardener?
The gardener. Name someone wives might flirt with during an average day.
Their husband.
They husband. Number five.
Hater.
Number four. Point values are double, ladies. Top six answers on the board, fill in the blank. Grandpa might flirt with the old ladies by showing them his what?
Wallet.
Wallet.
Pants. We gonna play.
We gonna play.
Yeah.
Demetrius, Grandpa might flirt with the old ladies by showing them his what?
His thing. Oh. That thing.
His thing. Natalie, how are you, darling?
I'm doing okay.
Grandpa might flirt with the old ladies by showing them his what?
His car.
His car. Vanessa, Grandpa might flirt with the old ladies by showing them his what?
His charming personality.
His charming personality. Come on now, we gotta slow it down. Come on, family, you gotta get it together. Two strikes, dating family can steal.
His smile, Steve, his smile.
Good answer, good answer.
His smile.
Good answer.
Careful, Dayton family can still got two strikes.
Jury.
Jury. Fill in the blank, Grandpa might flirt with the old ladies by showing them his what?
Viagra blue pills.
The Viagra blue pills. Four.
Muscles.
Three. Top eight answers on the board. This is funny. Here's a good one, ladies. Let's go. A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion if who starts looking sexy?
His mama.
His mama.
His dog.
His what?
His dog.
His dog.
Oh, 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 oh.
Pass or play?
We don't play.
We don't play. Hey, how you doing?
We're fantastic, Steve.
Yeah, what do you do?
I am a legislative assistant. I work for the state of Louisiana for the Louisiana Legislature for District 99.
Louisiana, boy, I've had some food down there.
Yes.
So
yes.
Who's the cook in the family?
It's a team, Steve. It's a team.
Well, who?
You're the cooking queen.
I'm the taster.
Yeah. Ryan said, yeah. Ryan said, yeah. It's a team, Steve. All of them can cook. Ask me. Ryan, when you taste test, who do you lean to a little bit?
Oh.
You have a favorite?
I ain't got crazy written on me, Steve.
Ryan said, I ain't got crazy written on me, Steve. Don't start nothing over here, dog. I ain't mad at you, Ryan. Giselle, a man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion if who starts looking sexy?
His mother-in-law.
Yeah. 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 The mother-in-law.
Yes. Yes.
Ryan, what do you do, man?
I am a freelance graphic designer, but Steve, I'm tired.
You're tired.
I'm tired, bro. I traveled here with four old ladies, my wife, and a baby.
I know you tired. Y'all drove up?
Man, we flew, and they got about 900 pounds of luggage between all these women.
Bro, you been carrying luggage?
All week.
Nice. Well, that's good. All right, Big Ryan. A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion if who starts looking sexy?
His sister.
His sister, oh. Yes. Yes.
His sister. Yes. Hey, Natalie, the chef. A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion if who starts looking sexy?
His brother. Woo!
You're finna get put out the reunion. His brother. Oh. All right, now.
Oh, come on.
Artilia?
Yes?
A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion. Who started looking sexy?
His grandmother.
His grandmother. A man knows he's had too much to drink at the family reunion of who starts looking sexy.
I know this because I'm one of them. His auntie!
Yeah, his
yes.
aunt.
Yes! 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 Yeah. Yes!
Big on Agnes! All right, where am I? Giselle. A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion of who starts looking sexy.
Your cousins.
Your cousins.
Yes, yes, yes,
Big Ryan, we got one answer left, man. You can clear the board. You only got one strike. Give it to me. A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion of who starts looking sexy.
All right, Steve, this ain't my answer. My wife right here, but I'm going to go with your wife.
The wife! All right, Natalie, we got one answer. You can clear the board, but this time you got two strikes. Bechtel family can steal. A man knows he's had too much to drink at a family reunion of who starts looking sexy?
His sister-in-law.
His sister-in-law! All right, guys, we got top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 married women, name something you ask your husband for using your sexiest voice. Fatima.
A new house.
A new house.
Yes.
New house.
Sex.
We're gonna play. Debbie, we talked to 100 married women. Name something you ask your husband for using your sexiest voice.
I want to have more children.
More babies! Kayla,
yes, sir?
Now, you a stay-at-home mom.
You know what I'm gonna ask for?
Oh, well, let me find out. Name something you asked your husband for using your sexiest voice.
His money.
His yeah! money. Okay, now, use your sexiest voice. Let me hear it and ask for the money.
Colton, I need some money.
You ask Colton like that, you still gonna be needing some money. Money! Name something you ask your husband before you use your sexiest voice.
How about a massage?
Ooh, a good. Massage. Megan, talk to 100 married women. Something you ask your husband before using your sexiest voice.
A new car.
Woo! A car! We got two strikes. We got to be careful now. Dorsey family can steal. Name something you ask your husband for using your sexiest voice.
A vacation.
We need a vacation. We ask 100 married women, name something you ask your husband for using your sexiest voice.
Jewelry.
Jewelry. Number seven.
Kisses!
Five.
Take out trash.
Two.
Food. Three.
Top seven answers on the board. We ask 100 women, name someone you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday. Terry.
Mother.
Your mother.
We're gonna play, Steve. Yeah.
Hey, Jesse, we ask 100 women, name someone you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
Your daughter.
Your daughter. Name someone you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
Your boss?
Yeah. Donnell, 100 women, name someone you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
Grandma.
Grandma. Lisa, somebody you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
My neighbor.
Your neighbor done probably seen Terry. Bet he won't skip his ass over there with a box. He ain't coming over there with a damn box of chocolates. What fool? Look at Terry talking about, hey, I got a little something for you. Well, Terry got something for you, too. Your neighbor. Terry, only one strike. Talk to 100 women. Give me somebody you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
The pastor.
The pastor. Jesse, we got two strikes. Got to be careful. Crosby family can steal. Talk to 100 women. Somebody you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
Your siblings.
Your siblings. Jasmine, Crosby family can steal. We got two strikes. Name somebody you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
Your lawyer.
Great answer. Great answer.
Your lawyer. Talk to 100 women. Name somebody you'd be surprised gave you sexy lingerie for your birthday.
Your uncle.
Your uncle. Number four.
Dog puppy.
Three.
Mother-in-law.
Top six answers on the board. Name something about Mr. Clean that women find sexy.
Bald head.
Bald head all day.
He cleans.
He cleans.
He cleans.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Nataki, name something about Mr. Clean women find sexy.
His goatee.
His goatee. Miss Teresa, how you doing today?
Oh, I'm fine.
Good, good. You? Name something about Mr. Clean women find sex.
His physique.
His physique. Yeah. Yeah. Go, how you feeling today, man?
I'm good, Steve.
Good, good. Give me something about Mr. Clean women find sexy.
I'm gonna say his all-white attire.
His all-white attire. Brandy, how are you today?
I'm well. How you doing?
All right, now, we got two strikes now. We got to slow this thing down a bit. The other family can steal. Tell me something women find sexy about Mr. Clean.
He started dancing.
Does dance.
Does dance.
Do you know who Mr. Clean is?
Yes, I do. Very recently, he started dancing
he started
in those commercials.
Dancing.
Yes, he did.
Really?
Yes.
Mr. Clean is dancing now?
Yeah. I thought it was a little weird, too.
What is he dancing for?
I don't know. Cleaning, because the house is clean. I get excited when the house is clean. I dance while I clean.
Anybody seen Mr. Clean dancing? Oh, y'all know about it? Well, they know about it.
Right, well, It's up there.
It could be.
Yeah, I hope it is.
I'm completely lost. I didn't even know he came off the bottle. I've never seen him talk or anything.
They had to change him up.
They've changed him up.
They had to change him up.
I be damned. Mr. Clean is dancing. Name something about Mr. Clean that women find sexy.
His smile.
His smile.
His smile?
His smile. Top 8 answers on the board. We asked 100 married women, your man looks sexiest when he's doing what? Lisa.
Looking into my eyes.
Looking into my eyes. Oh, that's great. Allison.
When he's working in the yard.
Working in the yard. Pass the point.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Yes.
Hey, Miss Deborah, talk to 100 married women now. Your man looks sexiest when he's doing what?
When he is wearing a suit.
When he's wearing a suit. That's a rule and a fact. Women love a well-dressed man. Don't ever forget that. Damn this survey. Megan, we ask 100 married women, your man looks sexiest when he's doing what?
Cleaning.
Woo! Cleaning. Amy, your man looks sexiest when he's doing what?
Working out.
When he's working out. Miss Peggy, your man looks sexiest when he's doing what?
Dancing.
Dancing. Yeah. We got 2 strikes now, Allison. We gotta be careful. Sanders family can steal. Your man looks sexiest when he's doing what?
When he's wearing nothing at all. Yeah.
When he's wearing nothing at all. Guys, we asked 100 married women, your man looks sexiest when he's doing what?
Taking care of the kids.
Taking care of the kids. Guess I'll be sexy tomorrow. The only time y'all think we sexy, we gotta be doing something. Yard work, working, caring for the kids, cleaning the dishes. Damn. Number 4.
Showering.
Okay, we're getting there. 3.
Cooking.
2. Top 6 answers on the board. We ask 100 married women, when thinking of your husband, what does the very thought of him make you want to do? Sam.
Squeal.
Squeal. You better go to work, Sam. Squeal. Eddie.
Smile.
Smile.
Pass the plan. We will play, Steve.
Let's go. Christine, we talked to 100 married women. When thinking of your husband, What does the very thought of him make you want to do?
Well, you know, Steve, I'm married to a very sexy, bald man.
Yeah.
And if I think of him, I just like to just moan. Close your ears, Sanjay.
That's a terrible answer.
When thinking of your husband, what does the very thought of him make you want to do?
Well, a lot of wives are unhappy, so I'm gonna say cry.
Yeah, that's a good answer.
My wife's gonna be happy though, Steve.
Your wife's gonna be happy.
Yo, she's gonna be ecstatic. Yeah.
Calm down.
Hell yeah, boy. You doggone right, she gonna be happy. Cry! Oh. All right now, Angel, we got two strikes. We gotta be careful, the other family can steal.
Sometimes it just makes me sick.
Good answer.
Just couldn't hide it no more. Now I'm just gonna tell you, it just make me sick.
Different husbands.
No, it works out sick. Talk to 100 married women, Miss Shirley. When thinking of your husband, what does the very thought of him make you want to do?
Orgasm.
Ooh, I wasn't ready for that one right there. Orgasm. Number six. Four. Number one. Top seven answers on the board. Name something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom right after giving him a shot. Jill.
Take a peek.
Take a peek.
Yeah, good answer! Yeah!
Wash it. Woo! Wash it.
Wash it.
Mm-hmm.
Wash it. All right, Kira, name something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom right after giving him a shot.
She's gonna squeeze it.
Squeeze it. Hey, Hannah, something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom after she's giving him a shot.
She might slap it.
Slap it.
Yeah.
Hey, Big Hunk, name something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom after giving him a shot.
Give it a smooch.
Give it a smooch. All right now. Yeah! Sean, we're rolling. Something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom after giving him a shot.
She's gonna get in trouble, but she's gonna rub it.
She's gonna rub it. Yeah.
Yeah!
Sean, she's gonna probably get in trouble for all of this. One answer left. We can clear the board, Jill. Name something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom after giving him a shot.
Maybe she's gonna go tell her nurse friends about it?
Gonna go tell her nurse friends. Only one strike, Kira. Something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom.
She might sniff it.
Yeah, I would.
Sniff it. Hannah. One answer left, but you got two strikes. Kelly family can steal. Something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom after giving him a shot.
She might do nothing.
She might do nothing. Name something a nurse might do to a sexy man's bottom right after giving him a shot.
Steve, you're gonna say cover it.
Cover it. Yeah. Top seven answers on the board. Name a city that's chock full of sexy people.
Yeah. Atlanta.
Atlanta. Boy, we know where you been. Melinda?
L.A., Steve.
L.A. Rebecca, name a city that's chock full of sexy people.
Vegas, baby.
Vegas!
Yeah,
Hey, Lauren, give me a city that's chock full of sexy people.
I'm gonna say Miami, Steve.
Oh, Lord. Miami! Joanna, name a city that's chock full of sexy people.
I'm gonna say New York, Steve!
New York!
Yeah, it's right there! Woo-hoo.
Well, it's gonna get a little harder now, ladies. Presley, who are you thinking it is? Give me a city that's chock full of sexy people.
Dallas.
Good. Dallas.
That's okay.
Oh, it's gonna get harder, Melinda. Give me a city that's chock full of sexy people.
What about Nashville? Southern.
Nashville. Woo! Rebecca, give me a city chock full of sexy people.
Well, what about Paris?
Yeah. Yes.
Paris. Oh. Lauren?
Chicago.
Chicago! That was a good answer, man. Tell you what, cause when they take them coats off in Chicago, they fine. They fine.
All righty.
I know y'all see me over here.
All right.
Name a city that's chock full of sexy people.
The fellas say Houston.
Ooh. Houston! Seven.
San Francisco.
Yeah, duh.
Five.
London.
All right, guys, top six answers on the board. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy. Monique.
Because he wears glasses.
Because he wears glasses.
Because he's smart, he's gonna make a lot of money.
Because he's smart.
We're gonna play, Steve.
All right. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
He's a sharp dresser.
He's a sharp dresser.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hello, Miss Robin. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good to have you. What do you do again?
I'm a retired teacher of 33 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, welcome back. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
Because of his pocket protector.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right here, the pocket protector.
Oh, you talking about that thing they put in there and then they put the pen. Yeah, I ain't never had one of them.
Yeah, yeah.
Gotta keep your shirt clean.
Because of their pocket protector.
Yeah.
Hey, Jake, how you doing, man?
Doing well, Steve.
Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
He drives that nice new Tesla. New
he
car.
Drives a... He drives a nice new Tesla. Oh. Bailey, we got two strikes. We got to be careful now. The other family can steal. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
The way he styles his hair. Yeah.
The way he styles his hair. Oh. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
Because he wears braces.
Oh. Jesus. Number six. Three. Number two.
They're hot.
Top seven answers on the board. Oh, this is so good. Name something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders. Allie.
His facial hair.
His facial hair.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Hey, Nancy, something sexy or a woman might say sexy about Colonel Sanders.
The fact that he owns his own business.
He owns his own business.
Good answer.
He owns his own business. Jewel.
Yeah.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
You ready? Name something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
All the fried chicken.
All the fried chicken. Big Dave, name something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
His white suit.
His white suit. Laura?
Yes.
Only one strike. Give me something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
His accent.
His accent. Allie, only one strike. Name something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
His money.
Yeah. His money! Yeah. Hey, Nancy, only one strike. Give me something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
The fact that he's on TV.
Oh,
yeah. He's on TV!
Good answer. Oh.
Jules, we got two strikes. You gotta be careful, the White family can steal. Name something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
That he's a colonel.
Yeah. That he's a colonel.
Good answer. Good answer.
Oh. All right, family, name something a woman might say is sexy about Colonel Sanders.
His white hair.
His white hair. Number seven.
Gordon's
top six answers on the board. Why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
Matt. He put his head right in the cake.
He put his head right in the cake.
His teeth fell out.
His teeth fell out. We're gonna play. Maria.
Yes.
So what do you do?
I'm a retired grandma. I spoil my grandkid. I feed them. I send them back home. I love to shop. I love to travel. And I'm a shopaholic. But I hate to cook. I don't like cooking. I like cooking.
All right, Miss Maria. Why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
His spit.
He what?
He spit.
He spit on the cake.
Yes. Yes.
Spit on it.
Maria? Maria, your name, what's your relation to her?
I am her daughter-in-law.
Okay, good. You got the same name, that's it.
Yeah.
And you're married to?
Sig.
And so you found your mother.
Yes, absolutely.
Exactly 100%. The same.
That's crazy.
All the way, including the cooking, sir.
I'm the lucky one. I'm the lucky one.
Maria?
Yes.
Why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
Because the candles did not blow out. They stayed lit.
Because the candles didn't blow out, they stayed lit. Steve, why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
Because he passed some gas, Steve.
He passed some gas. Sandro, why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
Because he fainted?
Because he fainted. He fainted? Only one strike, Kayla. Why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
I would say because the cake fell.
Oh, the cake fell! Yeah. All right, we got two strikes, Maria. We got to be careful. Wendland family can steal. Why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew the candles out on his birthday cake?
Because he had to rush to the bathroom.
Because what?
He's an emergency. Go to the bathroom.
He go now. Emergency. All right, guys. Why did everybody laugh when Grandpa blew out the candles on his birthday cake?
Burned himself. Fell over.
He fell over.
He fell over. Five.
Happy he could.
Top six answers on the board. Name a word starting with the letter S.
Sugar.
Sugar. Name a word starting with the letter S that describes Steve Harvey's head.
Sexy.
Sexy. Number five.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Number five.
Whoa.
Three damn people. Pass or play?
We're gonna play, Steve.
Julie, what do you do for a living?
I am a recent college graduate.
You better go, girl.
40 years in the making.
That's all right.
I am a 2-time stage 4 colon cancer survivor.
Wow. Twice?
Apparently, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, so someone thought I was Superwoman.
Yeah. That's pretty good. I like that. All right, brother, let's go. Name a word starting with S, describe my head.
Shaved.
Shaved, yeah. Jessica, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Okay, good. Name a word starting with the letter S to describe Steve Harvey's head.
Steve, your head is smooth.
As butter. As butter. Smooth.
Smooth.
Marcos, how you doing, man?
Doing well, Steve. Good to be here.
What do you do, brother?
I do a lot. I am a business consultant for a tech-based basketball training facility called Shoot 360. I also have alopecia areata, an autoimmune disease, which affects your hair follicles. So I try to make sure that I represent myself to the kids that I work with in a way that shows them, like, hey, you know, nobody's perfect. Stop worrying about having the coolest kicks, worrying about the latest fashion, and just be who you are. Have some good self-assuredness. I think that'll help make the world go around.
I tell you something, Mark.
Yes, sir.
If you hadn't said nothing to me, I wouldn't know nothing.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, let's go, man. Name a word starting with the letter S describe Steve Harvey's head.
Well, I've been bald myself, Steve, and it's always shiny. You got a nice shiny
head. Shiny! Bianca?
Yes, sir.
What do you do?
I am a case manager and youth counselor. Working with underserved communities in the city of Portland. Yeah. So I work to make sure that people stay together in their homes.
That's pretty good. All right, let's go. Name a word starting with the letter S to describe Steve Harvey's head.
I'm going to say silky. Looks very soft. Right.
Silky. Julie, we got one strike. Tell me a word starting with S to describe Steve Harvey's head.
I'm going to say special.
Okay.
You got a special head.
Good answer.
All right, man. Come on, we got two strikes, Keelers. We got to be careful. Denard family can steal. Name a word starting with letter S describe Steve Harvey's head.
We're going suave. Spanish. Suave.
Suave. Look like I done read you. Suave. All right, here we go. We got a word starting with letter S that describes Steve Harvey's head.
Soft.
Soft. Number six.
Strange.
Number four.